Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren.
And I'm Larry.
And in this video, we're going to talk about how to properly size a battery system for your home. So Larry, how does some homeowner know exactly what size and how many batteries they need in order to have a good backup?
So ideally, the homeowner would provide us with good information. That's one of the big challenges, getting good information. But what we're looking for is what's their continuous demand? Like how many watts, once their loads are started up, how many watts do those loads use? And then secondly, are there any startup watts? Are there any peak amps, which is going to make a higher demand initially when a load starts up? And then how many hours do they want to use each load every day? And then beyond that, how many days of backup do they want? So if we look at all those loads, how many days of backup do they want without any input from solar, like if it's snowy or cloudy or something like that?
For most homeowners though, Larry, or many homeowners, they don't know how many startup watts. They may not even know what watts are. They know they have a microwave, a fridge, they have all these different appliances and AC, and they want to use it. So how do they go about figuring out this information to give to you?
So there's a couple of ways we can do that. One, we can put a device, we can install a device on their breaker panel.
Yep.
And then they can tell us what loads they're interested in using. We can measure those loads. That's one way we can do it. Another thing we can do is just quote a more generic battery system, present them with that information, let them know approximately what loads it covers, and then kind of go from there. Is it, you know, in the ballpark of what they're looking to spend?
Okay, so now, Larry, let's assume I have all of this good information and I pass it on to you. What do you do with this information?
So we would use that information to size the inverter and to size the battery. And what we're looking at, again, is the startup watts versus the running watts. Can the inverter handle it? Can the battery handle it, both start up and running? And then is your battery bank big enough to handle all the loads you want to run for the hours you want to run them for the amount of time that you want to be able to run them without input from either the grid or the solar?
Okay. How does that get managed, which loads I want to choose? I know I want these. I want my refrigerator backed up. Do I need to tell you that beforehand? How does that work?
Yeah, so we would want to know which loads. And, you know, technically, you could get onto your breaker panel if there's an outage and flip off the breakers you don't want.
Sure.
But there's an alternative. And the alternative is an actual product where you can get an app on your phone and you can say, okay, there's an outage, I'm going to turn that load off. I'm going to turn off my water heater because that's a really heavy load. My batteries are getting low. In addition to that, some of these devices can actually flip loads off automatically in an outage. So in an outage, I'm turning off my HVAC, I'm turning off my water heater, some of those heavier loads so I don't drain my battery really quickly and so that I don't need as big of an inverter to power all those loads.
All right, Larry, so there's three main components here. The inverters, the batteries, and the load shedding. What do each of those components do?
So at a very basic level, the battery is your storage.
Yeah.
So no grid power, no solar power, maybe it's at night.
Yeah.
The battery is what stores the electricity. The inverter then is the go-between between the batteries and your loads to pull that power out of the batteries and feed your loads. So that's the inverter's job, to switch it from DC storage to AC that you can use in your home. And then the load management system simply manages the load. So most battery systems aren't built large enough to handle every load in your house at once like the utility could.
Sure.
They're smaller than that. So that's what your load management system's job is, to make sure that your inverter's not faulting off, that your battery's not running out of power, that it's managing those loads accordingly.
Yeah. If you'd like to learn more and figure out exactly how many batteries or inverters you would need for your home, we'll have a link to our battery calculator in the description below, and you'll be able to select your own loads and how many hours you want those loads to run, and it'll give you a ballpark price and a ballpark number of batteries and inverters that you need to build that system. Thanks for watching. We hope you found this valuable.